This video will demonstrate how to marcotte rambutans. We will discuss the entire process, how to create one, how to water it, and finally how to remove it.
I'm Greg Owens. I've been growing rambutans for about 15 years. Just today we'll give you a little bit of a rundown on our experience with marcottes and grafted rambutan trees. A couple of the advantages of the marcottes we've found: they are extremely stable. You get all sorts of rumours about them falling over in high winds. That certainly hasn't happened. They're quick to generate. We can have them in the ground in around about 8 to 9 months, as compared to probably 2 years for a grafted tree. And they start fruiting pretty much straight away. We've had fruit on these marcotted trees at about 2 years old, and they continue to be probably our best producers in the orchard.
Marcotting is a cut or wound on the branch of a plant. You make two parallel cuts all the way around, then a third cut joining them. Then you peel off a small layer of cambium and enclose the wound with peat moss until roots develop. You want your cincture or cut to be on the mature wood about the third flush from the tip. The first flush is green, the second flush is a little bit paler, and the third flush is a bit more mature. If your wood is too green, the knife will stick into the bark and it won't peel off cleanly. Remove your leaves from around the branch and choose a node for your cincture. Cut above and below the node. When you push the knife in, it will meet resistance and stop when it hits the hardwood. Don't push any further. You only want to remove the outer cambium layer. Make a circular cut all the way around for the first cut, and then a second cut a couple of centimetres along. Then slide the knife down the middle between the two circular cuts. Lift the bark and peel it off. It should pop off easily. If it doesn't, the branch was probably too green. You don't want to wait too long to pack the cincture with medium. Even after a couple of minutes, you will notice that it will start to turn brown and you will get oxidation on the surface of the hard wood. So with your bag of firmly packed peat, slice a line along the face of the bag to expose the peat. The roots are going to come from the top of the cincture, so you want it to be in the middle of the peat. Push the peat firmly around the cincture and make sure it has good contact with the wood. Take a plastic sleeve and wrap it around the bag. Once the sleeve is tight, use the cable ties to hold it in place at either end of the bag, not directly over the cincture. Tie up each end of the plastic to make a good seal and stop the peat from drying out. Don't use cable ties for this. If you tighten the ends too much, it creates a second cincture and you'll get rooting in the wrong place. Flagging tape has a bit more give than a cable tie and spreads the pressure evenly over a greater distance and is a better option. Keep the ends firm and twist them around before wrapping the flagging tape around to bind it together. If necessary, apply another cable tie to the peat moss to keep it tight. Once both ends are bound, apply some alfoil to keep the heat out. Some marcottes sit in full sun and will get too hot otherwise. Also, the foil provides a dark environment for the roots to develop. Finally, remove about 20% of the leaves from the tip to stop it from transpiring too much. Usually after a week or so, particularly in the dry season, they will need to be watered. Once you have made your marcotte, you need a way to keep them moist and water them on a weekly basis. We use a pump-up water sprayer with a nozzle modified to include a hypodermic needle on the end. This allows you to create enough pressure in the water to force it into the marcotte bag and to keep it wet. This marcotte is several weeks old. You can see the roots starting to form through the plastic. It needs another week or two before there are enough roots to remove it from the parent plant. Until then, it needs to be watered weekly to keep the peat moss from drying out. Using the modified bottle, inject the water directly into the peat moss. You can see the water spreading through the peat. Wrap it back up again and then leave it for another week. This marcotte is 5 weeks old. You can see the amount of roots that have formed through the plastic. It is very well developed and advanced enough to remove it from the parent tree. When you remove a marcotte from the parent tree, it is very stressful for the cutting. So make sure the peat moss is well watered first. Use the modified water bottle to pump water into the marcotte. Make sure there is plenty of water in the bag before you take it off. To remove the marcotte, simply sever it from the parent using secateurs. Immerse the marcotte in a bucket of water and make sure it stays wet until you get a chance to take the plastic off and pot it up in the nursery.